Well, you know, we all know Batman and Robin, but if there ever was a dynamic duo, here's one. Mandy Barnett and Harold Bradley, ladies and gentlemen. Wow.
Thank you. Thank you, Ray.
You know, Harold, I should have introduced you as Harold Ray Bradley, because you and I have the same first two names.
Absolutely, and it was always great, except when my mother called me and she said, Harold Ray, I knew I was in trouble.
Oh, that's right, yeah.
Other than that, it's worked really good.
Well, I didn't get called Harold Ray very often, but when I did, it was the same deal. I knew I was in trouble. But I've known Harold since I was 17 years old, and that was years ago. And when I first came to Nashville is when I met Harold. I was 17, and I had my first session at the old RCA studio, and Harold was one of the guitar players. And I went up to him, and I said, now, I got right down his face. I said, now, I want you to play just like that lick on that Tommy Sands record, A Teenage Crush, you know, where the guitar plays triplets. And he looked at me, and he said, okay, I think I know that. I played it on the Tommy Sands record. And I shut up after that.
Yeah, you were really in my face a little bit. And actually, recording was new in Nashville. We'd only been doing recordings for 10 years. And I was new to recording, too, so it made an impression.
Well, yeah, you mean you'd been recording for 10 years and you were new?
That's true, because there weren't that many recordings going on.
Well, yeah. Well, you know, it sure has bloomed since then, hadn't it?
Yeah, I did my first session in Chicago in 1946 with Pee Wee King. There were no studios in Nashville.
What are some of the records that you played on here?
Oh, gosh, a lot of the things that Mandy does, I played on Crazy. We had no headphones, no music, and we actually ended up doing a track after 4 hours because she couldn't hold out one of the notes on there.
Yeah, she had a car wreck, right?
Yeah, she had a car wreck, and when she held one note, it bothered her rib, and we ended up with a track. We made that track with no music, no headphones, and it's really a great track, you know.
Well, it certainly is. How did you meet Mandy? How did you two guys meet?
Well, I met Mandy when she won the audition to play Patsy Cline in Always Patsy, and they called Owen to come down and work with the musicians on the music. And a little brother got the job because Owen was putting in a kitchen up on the lake, and he sent me. We were sitting there, we were working over it, and like I was telling the drummer a while ago, what Buddy Harmon played on there, the dotted eighths and triplets, which makes the record a lot. We went through all of that, went through the bass lines, everything, and this girl never said a word. And so we went on and we rehearsed a lot of the music, and then finally I said the magic words, let's do a song. And we did Crazy, and then I knew what a brilliant vocalist that Mandy was at that time.
So you made a record with Owen and Harold, and how did that change your life?
Well, it totally changed my life. It was one of the greatest experiences of my life. I absolutely adored Owen and adored Harold, and it was called I've Got a Right to Cry. We made it in 1998, and from there on, me and Harold worked together in my band. We toured. We played Madison Square Garden. We did the Late Show with David Letterman, the Tonight Show. We played bars, festivals, theaters, just you name it. We've had a great time working together.
Well, listen, can we get you two to do that great song written by Willie Nelson and made famous by Patsy Cline and Harold and his brother Owen? Crazy? Let's do that.
Let's do it.
One, two, three.
Crazy. I'm crazy for feeling so lonely. I'm crazy, crazy for feeling so blue. I knew you'd love me as long. You'd leave me for somebody new. In the world did I do? Crazy for thinking that my love could hold you. And I'm crazy for loving you. Crazy for thinking that my love could hold you. I'm crazy for trying, and crazy for crying, and I'm crazy for love.